Right, let's get some Warhawk gameplay out the way. Bro, you can't do any of this. Can't even play online anymore, so it's gonna do training. Okay. So we'll start with ground combat. Introduction. This is your spawn. This is the spawn map. You can select the spawn point using directional buttons and enter the game by pressing X. In this scenario, where there's only one spawn position, which is selected by default, press X to enter the scenario. Okay. And I'm already there, so... Oh, there we go. Welcome to basic training. In this scenario, you'll learn how to fight and survive on the ground. Throughout these training scenarios, you'll see glowing waypoint indicators, like the one directly ahead of you. Each waypoint is new lesson. Use L to run the first waypoint. Okay, 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 nice. Basic movement. Using L, you can run forward, backward, and side to side. Use R to turn and look up and down. If you're left-handed, okay, I'll skip that. Press X to jump, circle to cross. Go to the next waypoint to continue. Crouch, jump, look. Okay. Pistol. The pistol is your most basic firearm. Use R to aim and tap L1 to fire. Or R1, sorry. Destroy the training drones using your pistol. Notice that the drones also appear in your mini-map. The upper right corner of the screen has red dots. Okay, I see that. Destroy the drones to continue. Why is it inverted? Oh my god. No, hold on. We gotta change this real quick. Much better. Much better. Success. If you prefer, you can also invert the side to side or up and down aiming direction from the options menu and adjust the aiming speed. If you had trouble aiming at the drones just now, then try experimenting with these options. I already did it, so go to the next waypoint to continue. Yeah, I don't like the inverted stuff. Rifle. The rifle is a rapid fire automatic weapon useful at minimum range. Use R to aim and hold L1 to fire continuously. Since you don't start with the rifle, you'll need to pick it up. Grab the nearby rifle pickup by running over it. Alright. Oh my god. Okay, your current weapon is displayed in the lower left corner of the screen. Hold down any directional button to expand the weapon across, which shows all the weapons you're carrying. To select different weapons, press this corresponding directional button. The rifle is on the right, so press the right to select it. The left? I don't know what button that is. Destroy the drones with the rifle beam. Oh, it's right, okay. Note that you can increase the accuracy of the rifle or any weapon by firing while it's crouched. You can also reload a rifle manually by reselecting it from the weapon cross. Oh wow, you can do that? This works for all reloadable weapons. Grenades are useful secondary weapons because they don't have to be selected from the weapons cross. Grenades are useful against both enemies, soldiers, and vehicles. They explode after a short time or immediately on impact if they hit their target directly. Pick up the grenades to continue. Oh my god, now I gotta go around, or I can just do this. Oh, that works. The number of grenades you're carrying appears to be next to the weapon cross in the bottom left corner of the screen. Okay, I see it. To throw the grenade, press L1. The higher you aim, the farther you throw the grenade. You may need to aim a little above your targets to hit them. Destroy the drone with the grenades to continue. He just randomly throws it. How are you supposed to hold L1? Success. One grenade is lethal to an enemy soldier if it explodes near enough to them. or hits him directly. Multiple grenades will be necessary for destroying armored vehicles. Go to the next waypoint. Alright. The rocket launcher is designed for taking out armored targets such as tanks and Warhawks. It includes a homing feature. Pick up the rocket to continue. The rocket launcher appears in the top slot of the weapon cross. Switch it by pressing up. Okay, that's up. Hold L1 while aiming at the target to require target lock. Once the lock is required, release R1 to fire the rocket. Lock on to destroy all the drones. Note that some targets cannot be locked on to. These include ground troops, 4x4s, and turrets. In these cases, you can dump fire the rocket by tapping rather than holding R1. Oh yeah, so they're holding the button. The flamethrower is a powerful close-range weapon. Thanks. Pick it up to kill somebody. So, the flamethrower appears in the upper left slot of the weapon cross. To select it, press down and right. Down and left. Hold R1 to fire. Of left. Keep in mind the flamethrower can also damage vehicles. If you can get close enough, it's a great mini tank weapon. To mount a ladder, stand next to it and press circle, or no, square. Once mounted, press L, look forward to climb up, pull back to climb down. You can also jump off quickly by pressing X. Climb to the top of the tower. Okay. The sniper rifle is designed for precision long-range attacks. Collect the sniper rifle and shoot the drones. Signal. There you go. Zoom in with R1 or R3. Press R3 again, zoom in further. Third time to lower the scope. Fire shot, pressing R1. Sniper all the drones continue. Don't forget, you could use your minimap to locate your targets. Well, I mean, I don't need to. They're all right there. Practice makes perfect with this weapon. In addition to soldiers on the ground, you can also snipe exposed targets out of vehicles. Also, the sniper rifle's high velocity rounds can pierce some armor, damaging 4x4s and Warhawks. You can use the binoculars to call in the devastating airstrike. Pick up the binoculars to continue. Zoom in your target with R3, then while holding your aim steady, hold down R1 to mark the target area. The airstrike will arrive after a few seconds. Destroy the drones with an airstrike. Target the glowing area to get them all at once. Alright, let's do it. Get the binoculars. Okay, come on, look down. Binoculars. And then just target there. Oh god. Jeez. These trained drones aren't too smart, but a real opponent can see and hear the binoculars target laser before the air strike arrives. Take this into account when painting targets. Go to the next point to continue. Alright. Oh, that'll get damaged. Proxy mines can stick to any surface and are detonated when the enemy gets too close. Pick them up to kill a drone. A drone is going to try to enter this base. Defend the base by placing mines at the entrance with the highlight area. To toss a mine, tap R1. Place 4 mines to continue. Oh my god. Did I know I'm gonna throw it? Alright, that works. Good job! You can see how important proximity mines are establishing an effective defense. Go to the waypoint to continue. Uh-oh, knifing him? Oh, shit. About to kill me. You've been injured. You can see your health in the bottom right corner of the screen. Luckily, there's a battlefield nearby. This device is placed like a proxy mine and emits the healing field around it. Get and deploy the battlefield and stand near it to heal your injuries. Okay, just pick it up. Be healed. Got selected. And then what? R1? Oh, I'm staying on top of it. Okay. Success, you're back to full strength. This healing effect marks the battlefield an effective defensive tool since you are much harder to kill while standing within the field. Also, the field will slowly damage any enemies that stand on it, making it useful if conventional weapon. Your knife can- oh, now we do the knife, huh? Your knife can kill a soldier in one hit, quickly and quietly. Luckily for this exercise, it also works on the training drones. Sneak up on the drones and kill them all with the knife to continue. Hopefully they don't shoot me. Jeez. It's loud. Jump on. Uh-huh. Congratulations! You finished ground combat training. Yes! Ground Pounder. Hell yeah. You are now a certified ground pounder. Now that you got the basic understanding of infantry combat, you should move on to the vehicle combat scenario to learn to use the 4x4s, tanks, and turrets. See you there. Vehicle combat. Welcome to the vehicle combat training. To get the most out of the scenario, we recommend you complete the ground combat training first. I already did it. In this scenario, you'll learn to drive and fight with 4x4s, tanks, and turrets. This is the 4x4. It's a fast, lightly armored vehicle with a .50 caliber turret attached to the back. Get in the 4x4 to get started. Stand next to the left side door and press square to get in. Okay, so we're gonna walk up to the circle. Stand next to the car, press square. Ooh, sorry. To drive the 4x4, hold L2 to accelerate and use L to turn. Hold L2 to brake or drive in the reverse. You can also do a power slide by holding L2 and R2 while turning. Follow the road to the waypoint to continue. Oh my god. It was too soon for that. To switch these, hold square. A diagram of the vehicle will appear in the lower right corner of the screen. While holding square, use the directional buttons to highlight the seat you want to switch to. Then release square to switch. Switch to the 50 cal turret now by holding. Oh, circling it up. Okay. Oh, circling down. Let me squaring down. There you go. Use the arm to aim the turret, then hold L1 to fire. You can manually reload the turret by pressing any directional button. Alright, short turns. And it's inverted. Right. Well done. Switch back to the driver's seat and press left to follow the road next to the waypoint. Alright. Time to step up in the firepower. Press square to get out of the X4X4, then go get in the tank instead. Oh my god! To drive in the tank, hold L2 to accelerate and L2 to turn. Use L2 to brake or drive in reverse. Use R to aim for the aim the cannon and tap L1 to fire. Sort of drone fire. Oh. that one. Guess that again. Switch to the top hatch by holding square and pressing up. Down, I mean. Tank support hatch. Press triangle to open the hatch. You'll be able to use any weapons you collected, but you'll be exposed to enemy fire. Press triangle again to close the hatch and take cover. For this exercise, you've been given a rocket launcher. Open the hatch and destroy the drones with the rocket launcher. Alright. Wow. Driving a tank with a fellow soldier in the support hatch can greatly increase your effectiveness. Use teamwork to prevail. Move to the next waypoint. Oh. Stationary 50 cal turns are excellent in anti-infantry defenses, and not too shabby against armored vehicles either. Climb the slope and get on the one of the 50 cal turns by standing near it by pressing square. Oh my god, that scared me! Jeez, the stationary 50 cal works just like the one on the LRX, or aim with R, L1, or R with a fire. You could directly reload by pressing any directional button. Use a turret to destroy the turret. Oh my god, it's fast. Move to the next waypoint. Alright. Da na 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 na. Flank turns are useful against enemy aircraft, but not very effective against ground turns. Get in the tank, continue the flank turn to turn. Aim the flank turn with R and hold L1 to fire. R1, I keep saying L1. Ah. With the .50 cal, you can reload by pressing directional button. Destroy the drones with the flank to flak. Whatever it is, do continue. Oh my god. Ooh, to the next waypoint. I have a gun now. I'm into my pistol. Missile turrets are more powerful than flank turrets, but the missiles they launch can be dodged by skilled pilots. However, they're also most useful against ground targets. Get in the missile turret to continue. Let me guess, move around with R1 to shoot. Oh, lock on the target and reset fire. You can also dump fire a missile. Short the drone with the missile turret to continue. Let's pause this one. I'm gonna hold on. It'll take a lot of real. The wrench can be used to repair friendly unmanned vehicles and damage enemy vehicles. It replaces your knife, but it can be used just like the knife to attack enemy soldiers. Alright. It's basically just a knife. A repaired knife. Use the wrench to repair both damaged vehicles and destroy the drone. Best way to fucking repair, unlike Battlefield. Is that it? Okay, well, we're done. Congratulations, you completed this training scenario. Hell yeah, combat driver. Now that you got some experience on the ground, it's time to take the skies with Warhawk combat training. See you there. All right, Warhawk combat. Sponsored by Multiplayer Only. Welcome to the Warhawk combat training. To get the most out of this scenario, we recommend you complete the ground combat and the vehicle combat scenarios first. I already did it. Nice. In this lesson, you'll learn how to fly and fight with the Warhawk. Press X to get started. Well, actually, I want to change the controls before I do that. Because I already know it's inverted. Yep. Alright, we're good. You're currently in hover mode. Use L to move forward, back, and side to side, and use R to turn. Hold R2 to ascend, and L2 to descend. Hover toward the tall building ahead to continue. Pace it back. To switch to flight mode, press triangle. Press it again to switch back to hover mode. Flight mode, the Warhawk's always moving forward. Use L to turn and pitch up and down. Hold R2 to speed up or L2 to slow down. Press triangle to switch to flight mode and take her for a test drive. Okay. Afterburner, let's open her up to see what this machine can really do. While in flight mode, double tap R2 to fire the afterburner. If you hold R2 on the second press, you can fire the afterburner continuously until the meter in the lower right corner of the screen is empty. Try out the afterburner to continue. Whoa. Advanced flight. You can perform an aerial power slide by holding L2 and R2 when turning. This is used for throwing boogies off your tail. You can also perform special maneuvers by using R. These are different depending on which flight control mode you're using, arcade or pro. The flight control mode can be set in the options menu. Perform an aerial power slide to continue. Oh, is that it? Okay. To fire your machine, hold L1. Machine guns heat up over time and sustained fire will cause them to overheat and shut down temporarily. Keep an eye on the heat meter on the lower left corner of the screen. Destroy the drones with the machine guns to continue. You can track the drones by looking at the red dots on the minimap. Swarm missiles. To lock on a target, get close enough for the reticule to turn red, then hold L1. Release L1 to fire. Multiple swarm missiles could be locked into a single target. You can also move the reticule over multiple targets to lock a few missiles to each. Destroy the drones with swarm missiles. Continue. So hold L1. Why it was on hover? Oh, that's right. Let's do this. There we go. homing missiles. To lock on a target, get close enough for the reticle to turn red, then hold L1. You release L1 to fire. Homing missiles are more powerful than swarm missiles and take longer to lock on. Also, you can try to lock on one target at a time. Destroy the drone with the homing missiles. Continue. Lightning Shell. The Lightning Shell has two firing modes. Tapping L1 emits a short-range zap which can be fired quickly. You can also charge a massive burst by holding L1 until the outer ring of the reticule is fully filled in. Release L1 to fire. The burst damages all targets near the impact point for several seconds. Destroy the drone with the Lightning Shell to continue. Alright. Oh my god. Damn it. What? What am I supposed to do? Okay. I don't like this weapon. What? Alright, you dying slowly. Tow missile. The tow missile is a devastating remotely guided weapon. Press L1 to fire. Your view switches from that switches to that of the tow missile, which you can now guide by using L. Hold R2 to speed up the missile. Press L1 to detonate the missile in the flight. Throw the drones to tow missile. Did I get that? I can't even tell. There we go. Cluster Bomb. The Cluster Bomb is dropped from the underside of the Warhawk by pressing L1. It's useful against ground target as an explosive cluster to tend to spread over a large area. So the drones with the cluster bombs to continue. Did I even hit them? That didn't do anything. This was detonate by the time I land or something? I don't look like it's getting them. I think I'm not hitting it. Dropping it at them. Oh, there we go. Oh my god. Gone. Air mines are deployed behind you by pressing L1. They float in place until triggered or destroyed. When an enemy aircraft flies near your air mine, it will detonate, damaging or destroy him. Deploy two air mines to continue. Deploy where? There. Okay. Stealth makes you partially invisible and blocks your radar signature, so enemies can't see you on your minimap. It also interferes with the target locking mechanisms, preventing enemies from locking rockets and missiles onto you. Toggle stealth on and off by pressing L1. Activate stealth to continue. Stealth is now active. Enemies won't be able to get missile locks on you, but any locks that they already have will not be broken, so don't let your guard down. Also keep in mind that stealth provides no protection against flint. If flint shells start popping around you, it's time to get out of here. Oh wow. Basic missile scrubbing. Missile scrubbing is art of evading missiles once they're locked into you. You can do this by maneuvering various aerial maneuvers with R. Some drones are going to start firing missiles at you. Watch for the missile lock indicator in the top center of your screen. Then maneuver to scrub these missiles. Survive for 60 seconds to continue. If you are destroyed, you can respawn charge. Yeah, I got hit once. Oh, okay. Just fly away so they don't attack me. Advanced missile scrubbing. Or what? Okay. Swarm missiles are fairly easy to scrub, but homing missiles are more difficult. The missile turret is the most dangerous of all. If you get into the jam, you can use chaff to immediately break all the locks on you by pressing L1. The drones are going to fire a mix of missile types now. Be sure to collect some chaff and don't be afraid to use it. I'm all the way over here. Use it! Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Ooh. That was crazy. Jeez. That's crazy. Weapon cross. The Warhawk uses a weapon cross just like the ones you learned about ground combat training. Select the weapon, press your extra button towards the weapon position on the weapon cross. All the weapons you learn about are now available via pickle scatter throughout the area. Collect some weapons to prepare for your final exam. Oh, great. Hmm. Yeah, I'm about to die. What the hell? With some weapons. That's not even everything I'm collecting. Okay. As they say, the best defense is a good offense. Just dodging missiles alone may keep you alive, but it's not going to stop the opponent from attacking you. To truly excel, you need to learn to dodge missiles while simultaneously attacking your opponent. It's time to prove that you got what it takes. Stay alive and destroy those drones. Great. I've already told you, one hit left. That's all you need. Missiles are scrubbed when you change directions quickly. Doing the same maneuver over and over isn't very effective, as missile target systems are able to handle repetitive flight patterns. Instead, use hard turns, climbs, dives, and change up your maneuvers frequently. Survive for 60 seconds to continue. What the hell? Mine of somebody. Not gonna kill him, is it? Oh, I think it did. Oh my god! Shit! God damn. He said 10 missiles at me? That is some crazy shit right there. Kill you anyways. You'll be alright. Where are you at? Okay, stop spinning like that. Yo, you're not dead? This man's just gonna kill me 10 times before I even get him. Let me at least aim at you. Oh my god, that's crazy. Shoot. Congratulations, you're now ready to take on disguise in online matches. Pilot's license. You'll face some intense battles, but practice makes perfect. Find some allies, try new techniques, and learn from your mistakes. And you'll come out on top. See you in the battlefield. Well, too bad servers are shut down, so can't play this no more.